Hello, my name's Scott, and I'm going to show you how to install a GBAccelerator overclocking chip into a Game Boy Advance. You're going to need a few tools. A tri-wing screwdriver. It looks sort of like a Phillips, but it's only got three lobes. A small Phillips screwdriver. Small needle-nose pliers. Bigger needle-nose pliers. Small wire cutters. Wire strippers that can strip 30-gauge wire. A pair of scissors. A soldering iron with a fine chisel or conical tip, and some rosin core solder. Begin by disassembling the Game Boy Advance. Using your tri-wing screwdriver, remove the six screws from the back of the case. Underneath the battery cover, there is one additional screw to remove. This one is probably Phillips, but may also be tri-wing. The back cover should lift off of the Game Boy at this point. Remove the L and R buttons, plastic side pieces, and power switch cap. Remove the screws that hold the PCB into the Game Boy case. Disconnect the ribbon cable for the LCD screen. This can be done by sliding the brown or black plastic retaining bracket away from the body of the connector. This will release the cable so that you can slide it right out. Set all the case pieces aside for now. The GBAccelerator replaces the stock crystal in your Game Boy Advance, so you'll need to remove it. The easiest way to do that is to grab onto it with a pair of needle-nose pliers and gently rock it until it comes off the board. Be very careful not to lift any of the pads from the board. Inside the bag your GBAccelerator came in, you'll find the chip itself and a piece of double-sided tape. Peel the protective backing off of one side of the tape and stick it to the back of the GBAccelerator chip. Use a pair of scissors to trim the excess tape off. Peel the remaining backing off of the tape and stick the chip to the PCB at the location shown. Now it's time to start hooking up wires. First, add a little blob of solder to each of the solder pads on the GBAccelerator. It doesn't matter what order you connect the wires. I'm going to start with ground. Solder one end of the ground wire to the ground pad on the GBAccelerator. Run the wire to the pad marked GND on the Game Boy PCB so you'll know how long it needs to be. Cut the wire. Strip the end, then solder it to the Game Boy's ground pad, adding a little more solder if necessary. Make sure all your solder joints are clean and smooth. You don't want any giant globs or spikes. Next, do the power wire. Solder one end to the V+ pad on the GBAccelerator. Run the wire to the pad marked S1 on the Game Boy board. Cut it, strip it, solder it. The clock wire comes next. The procedure is the same as for the power wire. Run the wire from the clock pad on the GBAccelerator to the pad marked CK1 on the Game Boy PCB, routing the wire around any large components. Note, the remaining pads won't already have solder on them, so add a little blob of solder to each pad before you attach the wire. To connect the LED output, run a wire from the LED pad on the GBAccelerator to the Game Boy pad marked DL2A. Now it's time to hook up the button inputs. In normal control mode, you press all three selected buttons at once to switch clock speeds, so it doesn't matter which button connects to which input. Starting with GBAccelerator version 2, however, you have the option to enable up-down control mode, which has separate buttons to adjust the clock speed up or down. If you think you might want to use this, do pay attention to which button is connected to which input. The inputs are labeled S for select, U for up, and D for down. You can use this chart to decide which buttons you want to use and connect the inputs to their corresponding Game Boy solder pads. I'm going to connect the button inputs to select, R for up, and L for down. Run the wires as you did before, but make sure not to route them within any of the areas of the PCB that get covered by the rubber contact pads for the buttons. Also, avoid any large components and holes in the PCB. Once you have all the wires hooked up, reconnect the LCD ribbon cable. Insert the cable into the connector until it stops, then slide the plastic bracket back toward the body of the connector. This will lock the cable into place. Set the PCB down into the case. As you do, make sure the speaker drops into its little speaker cubby so that the board can seat properly. Reinstall the PCB screws. Replace the L and R buttons, plastic side pieces, and power switch cap. Make sure the handle of the actual power switch is sitting in the notch in the switch cap. Set the back cover onto the Game Boy and replace all the remaining screws. Install batteries, the battery cover, and a game. Now it's time to test out your handiwork.